Hi, my name is Chris and this is Battle Nonsense. The freedom to choose how you want to experience a game is one of the main reasons why many people choose the PC as their preferred platform. It's up to you if you want to trade FPS for a more cinematic experience where you set all graphic options to epic, or if you want to sacrifice visual fidelity in favor of a silky smooth high frame rate. So because of this, PC gamers expect that games are well optimized and provide many options which allow the player to fine-tune the game until it fits his needs and gets the most out of his hardware. What gamers don't like is when a game comes with limitations, like a hard-coded FPS limit, or when it is so poorly optimized that it won't even run properly on high-end hardware. Both applied to PUBG for a very long time, as the frame rate was limited to 144 FPS, and even I had troubles to get the game to run at more than 120 FPS when I did my first network delay tests. Since then, the developers have improved the performance of the game client, which increased the frame rate, but there is still room for improvement. With update 19, they also removed the 144 FPS limit and made the Unreal Engine's built-in FPS limiter, as well as the smooth frame rate feature available inside the options menu. In here, you can now set an FPS limit that is applied while you are inside the menu, which reduces the load on your CPU and GPU, which means less heat and less noise. Then you can set an FPS limit that is applied when you are playing the game. Unlimited allows your FPS to go all the way up to 300, and this option then also reveals the smooth frame rate setting, but more on that a little bit later. Custom allows you to enter a specific frame rate, which is especially useful if you own a G-Sync or FreeSync display. And display-based will match the FPS limit to the refresh rate of your display. So if you play on a 60Hz display, then the FPS limit is set to 60. On the 144Hz display, the FPS limit is set to 144, and so on. That said, unlike most other games, PUBG does not provide an option to select the refresh rate. It will simply use whatever rate you set for the Windows desktop, which means that PUBG might not even run at the highest display refresh rate supported by your monitor. Now, you can try to set the specific refresh rate by editing the launch options for a game inside of Steam. However, while this works nicely for CSGO and other games that use the Source engine, PUBG simply ignores these parameters. So, if you have a 144Hz display and want PUBG to run at 144Hz, then you must select that refresh rate for the Windows desktop, which might cause that text gets harder to read. So, this is something that the developers should really look into for a future update. Now, how much input lag do you get in PUBG? To test the responsiveness or button-to-pixel delay of a game, I use a high-speed camera and a gaming mouse which has an LED connected directly to the switch of the left mouse button. To measure the delay, I simply point my high-speed camera at the monitor and then record what happens when I press the left mouse button. Inside the high-speed footage, I then look for the frame where the LED turns on, and then I count the frames until I see the action triggered by that input, which then allows me to calculate the delay between the button and the pixel. Now, to find out how good or bad PUBG's input lag is, we must compare it to something. CSGO has one of the lowest input lags that I have measured yet, at 180Hz, 300 FPS and all graphic options set to the lowest value, I measured an average button to pixel delay of 14.67 milliseconds. When I did the same test in PUBG, I measured about 5 milliseconds more input lag on average, which is pretty much one frame at 180Hz, so that is quite a good result. However, I doubt that anyone can actually maintain such a high frame rate while playing the game. So, how much lag do you get when you set the built-in FPS limit to 140? As you can see, that causes a very minor input lag increase. But what if you are still on a 60Hz display and use the built-in FPS limiter to lock the frame rate at 60 FPS? This then increases the average input lag to about 30 milliseconds, or nearly 2 frames at 60 FPS. Now, what if you play the game at a frame rate that is higher than your display's refresh rate? This then slightly reduces the button-to-pixel delay because the game processes your input at frame time. So the higher your frame rate, the sooner your input gets processed by the game, which means that you get less input delay. I also want to mention that your ping to the server has no impact on the input lag. Even at a ping of 500 milliseconds, you get the same button-to-pixel delays, as the game client does not wait for the response of the server before it fires your gun or moves your player model. The server only forcefully corrects the client if the server disagrees with the client's prediction of what the player's input resulted in. The client immediately responds to your input, which is why you can get a low input delay even at a high ping. The negative impact that a high ping has on your online experience is a different topic. Now, all the results that I showed you so far are from tests where VSync was not enabled, which means that you get tearing. If you enable VSync, then this will instantly eliminate tearing. However, this will lead to back pressure inside the render pipeline, since the graphics card must now wait for the scan of the front buffer to complete before it can begin to render the next image. And so you get a massive input lag increase, as you can see here. If you want to know more about tearing and how VSync, G-Sync, FreeSync and FastSync work, then you can find a link to that video in the description down below. Now, what happens if you use RTSS or the River Tuner Statistics Server instead of the built-in FPS limiter? At 180 Hz and an FPS limit of 140, RTSS does cause slightly more button-to-pixel delay. However, that difference is less than one frame at 140 FPS. At 60 Hz and an FPS limit of 60, RTSS increases the input lag by about 10 milliseconds on average. But that is also less than one frame at 60 FPS. So when you look at this data, then you see that higher frame rates lead to less input lag. And when you combine a high frame rate with a high refresh rate display, then you can get the delays down even further. However, the key difference between playing a game at 140 FPS on a 60 Hz display compared to a 180 Hz display is not that you get 6 milliseconds less input lag. The difference is that the game feels a lot smoother, as the 180 Hz monitor is actually able to show you those 140 frames per second, while the 60 Hz display is physically unable to show you more than 60 frames per second. This means that playing games at a high frame rate on a high refresh rate monitor causes that the game feels smoother and more responsive. Also, tearing is less intrusive and motion blur is reduced as well. If you want to get rid of tearing in a fast-paced multiplayer game, then you really want to stay away from VSync, because that causes a massive input lag increase. And for it to work correctly, it also requires that your PC can produce a frame rate that at least matches your display's refresh rate at all times, which is quite a challenge when you have a monitor with 120 Hz or more. If you want to get rid of tearing, then you should look into AMD's FreeSync and Nvidia's G-Sync, which you can find more info on in the video that I link to in the description down below. Now, how about that smooth frame rate option? In this example here, the built-in FPS limiter is set to unlimited and smooth frame rate is disabled. What this feature should do is monitor my frame rate and then dynamically adjust the FPS limit to ensure a relatively stable frame rate. However, as soon as I enable that setting, PUBG runs at just 60 FPS. So why is that? When you go to the project settings inside of the Unreal Editor, then you will find these settings here for the smooth frame rate feature. And I guess that PUBG uses 60 FPS here for the max frame rate, which would explain why I get just 60 FPS as soon as I enable it. So unless your PC is unable to run the game at more than 60 FPS, you should stay away from that setting, at least for the moment. Now, what you will also notice here is that the frame rate is not exactly stable, even when I use the built-in FPS limiter to lock the frame rate at 60. However, if you choose unlimited inside the game and then use RTSS to limit the frame rate, then you will get an extremely consistent frame rate and frame time, which means that the game feels very smooth. That said, it will also cause about one frame of extra input lag. But to be honest, I doubt that you will be able to notice that even when you play at 60 FPS. The real downside of RTSS is that it can interfere with capture tools like OBS, so that is something that you need to keep an eye on. Now, if you want the lowest and consistent input lag in PUBG, or any other game for that matter, then you must make sure that your mouse and keyboard use the highest supported polling rate, you must ensure that the game uses the highest refresh rate supported by your monitor, you must optimize the graphics settings to get a high frame rate, you must stay clear of VSync, and then limit your frame rate to a value that your PC can maintain, so that you always get about the same amount of input lag and so a consistent gaming experience. And that's all for today. If you enjoyed this video, then it would be great if you could support me on Patreon. Without the awesome support that I get from my patrons, Battle Nonsense would simply not exist anymore. You can find the link to my Patreon in the description down below, where you will also find links to my social accounts in case that you want to stay up to date on the videos that I'm working on. So if you enjoyed this video, then please give it a like, subscribe for more, and I hope to see you next time. Until then, have a nice day and take care. My name is Chris, and this was Battle Nonsense.